Stoned Chakra.
Bitches. Next up on Stoned Chakra Reacts, we got a request coming from Patreon. This one is from Dean. Shout out to Canada. This one's from Merkules. Scars. There we go.
Yo, I was 16, thought I was the man, cause I was rapping, always partying and drinking, never thinking what could happen. I remember when I went and hit the studio, I was nervous, me and Snack writing verses, I'm thinking who'd have known. I felt I almost had something to prove, so I was acting hella stupid after chugging some booze. Really thought I was the man, looking up to the crew, but all my homies thinking, Merk, what the fuck's up with you? Then we finished all the writing, it was time to record. I didn't know what I was doing when I opened the door into that booth. Yeah, I got it, but it took me a while. And when I heard the finished product, I just looked with a smile. So we finished up the session, I was on my way home. All my friends knew about it, so they blew up my phone. Had me stressing, asking questions like, yo, how'd it go? I knew that when I hit the party, I just put on a show. Yo, it's funny how your whole life can change in a day. That's the way that things go when you're making a name. I'm turning nothing into something, I'm just paving my way. Pass that motherfucking mic or I might take it away. Yo, it's funny how your whole life can change in a day. But that's the way that things go when you're making a name. I'm turning nothing into something, I'm just paving my way. Pass that motherfucking mic or I might take it away. So I went and got my shit, then we met up with some friends, and I showed them all the track from the start until the end. So excited, I decided it was time to celebrate. I went and bought a bottle, but we showed up kinda late, and the spot that we were at was filled with older dudes. I got drunk and stayed quiet and chilled. I know the rules, then it got late. Homie said it's time for us to go. We couldn't get a ride and started walking in the snow. It was me and my girl, my buddy and his chick. It was New Year's night, we were chugging that Twix quick. Couple other homies with us, we were on our way home when a car almost hit us driving right off the road. I'm yelling slow down, but he didn't like the sound of that. Pulled over, got out of his car like he was down to scrap. What a tough guy, trying to pick a fight with us. Even took a swing, except he missed because the guy was drunk. Yo, it's funny how your whole life can change in a day. People love talking shit, let them say what they say. Just be you, all that bullshit ain't gonna stay.
I'm really invested, I
want
to hear the end
of
the story now.
Learn to be the better person, what are they gonna say? Yo, it's funny how your whole life can change in a day. People love talking shit, let them say what they say. Just be you, all that bullshit ain't gonna stay. Learn to be the better person, what are they gonna say? As he jumped into his ride, he said he'd be back to find us. That was when two cars just pulled up behind us. The doors open and some dudes jumped out. Masks on with machete swinging, two arms out. So I'm running trying to get away, but in a state of shock, I was screaming for my life. I just want to make them stop. Got knocked out with a bat, they were taking me out. Then I remember buddy put a switchblade in my mouth. We were only a kilometer away from my house. I'm thinking I'm about to die, I was facing a doubt. Stopped breathing, I was bleeding, couldn't make any calls. And then I seen a big machete headed straight to my skull. Took one across the cheek, took one across the forehead. Crazy, I'm a breath away from laying on the floor dead. My homie Jordan was nuts, he wasn't having it, swinging at these suckers relentless while they were stabbing them. They grabbed the girls and tried to drag them in the car, but they were screaming so loud they didn't make it very far. Then I blacked out. Later I woke up in the hospital, surrounded by my family and friends, like who's responsible? So confused I couldn't answer any questions. But since then I stuck to the music, so it's a blessing. If that didn't happen, who knows just where I'd be. Probably dead or in jail, so here's a thank you from me. And yo, the crazy part is, in that song I did with Snack that day, he says in his verse, in my neighborhood you cook a shot or stab, being in the wrong place at the wrong time. And just a couple hours after leaving the studio, that shit really happened to me. That fucks with me to this day, man. Live every day like it's your last, count your blessings. You only got one life to live, right? Don't fuck that up. Merk.
Canada don't play. Oh my God, they whipped out the machetes on my boy. You, my boy. You've mutilated my boy. What have you done? What have you done to my boy? What the fuck? Like, that just seems unnecessarily serious. Like, what the fuck was Merkules into? Were dudes he tells somebody to slow down, and that turns into machetes and switchblades. That's fucking insane. Bruh. Oh my god.
You want to know how I got these scars?
Doing the fucking Joker lick it. Oh my god, that's crazy. But another fucking thing that he said was the shit, how he had that in the song that he recorded in the studio just a few hours before that shit happened. Again, that's why I've been what I consider a little bit slow to put out new tracks, and that's why Flux took me so long. It's because ever since Resonance, I've been like very careful. Ever since What's Love Got to Do with It and Resonance, I've been very careful with what I say when I'm writing, because, and again, this is anecdotal, this is just my personal experience, too much of that shit has come to pass. And Resonance and before, I was not being methodical or really thinking about the input, because I just thought I was writing rhymes. I didn't realize that they had that much power. Like, once more than a few things that I had written about came to pass, I was like, I have to be very methodical with what I write next. And that's how I've been writing ever since. Again, I just thought it was interesting that he pointed that out, because that's something that I have experienced. But that's enough jabber, John. It's time for the question that I haven't asked in a long time, because I've kind of been frightened off reactions, but I know Merc is safe. The question is, did you like that? Did you enjoy Merkules? Did you enjoy what he had to say? Did you enjoy the beats? Did you enjoy the bars? Because if you did, feel free to go ahead and check out more Merkules. Check me out. Stoned Chakra, baby. Stop playing. Stop playing games. Like, subscribe. All the things. Do them. No one's gonna save us.